yards. So as guys are trying to find that extra edge of speed, you might see Bush running really fast, and all of a sudden he just drops off because he's pushing a little bit too hard.
Yeah, he'll drop off about 15 seconds, get right back at 90-50, maybe 5 seconds, he'll get right back up and take off again. Let's take a look at the guys exiting turn two. It still looks like, is that J.D. Byrider or Orton Custom right in front? Orton Custom, I mean, out front, it's going to be...
You're seeing him dive into that inside dog leg. That does look like Orton Custom Marine.
And Mike DeFries on the, I think he's driving right there. He's doing a good job. And oh, he's driving on the inside. There goes J.D. Byrider trying to make a move on the inside. Heading towards turn five, but does not gain an advantage right now. It looks like Orton Custom Marine. Second place, J.D. Byrider. Third place, looks like Peters and May. Fourth place, can't tell that is yet, Mark.
Yeah, that is Oregon Custom Marine out in the lead, followed by J.D. Byrider. Third place on Cali Grand Prix, gets past Peters and May on the inside. Fourth to third. Now New may have some ground on the hot lap, Charlie. He had a little bit of a problem here at the start,
but he's looking his way back up. Now he's running on sixth. And we got seventh place. I think that's Mandigo. No, that's sixth place. Seventh place is, I don't know. Can't tell the name of that one. Start down at top 8 is Miss Madison with the Black Brothers.
Run a little off the pace. Looks like they're running the boat a little bit tight, which in our vernacular means they have to drive it a little bit more, running on the nose of the boat a little bit.
Well, this is the first place. They still got to keep the boat in competition with boat weight, charging left and right, and they're going to figure it out pretty quickly if they're anything like their father. Joey, we've taught those guys very well to be very competitive in racing, but it looks like still out front is going to be Orton Custom Marine, second place, J.D. Byrider, third place, not sure yet if it looks like Ocala knows Peters and May, and Ocala Grand Prix running in fourth. That's the top four boats right now at the end of the first lap.
Now they're doing a 10-lap session. These all have hydraulic steering, but there's no power. These guys get out of these boats just whipped after running on them, especially with the left and right-hand turns. They really got to work on this dog leg as Oregon Custom Marine dives to the inside. They have clean water out in front. Sliding the boat around second place right on his tail is J.D. Byrider. He tries to take an inside lane. Now we'll see what he does as he's going to come across the wake and try to shorten his line. Peters and May is still in fourth place. They drop back as Ocala Grand Prix got past by just a little bit.
Yeah, but he took a light lead, but he did get by Peters and May. So Ocala is back up to third now. As we take a look at first place coming by, Orton Custom Marine, second place, J.D. Byrider, third place, Ocala Grand Prix, fourth place is Peters and May, fifth place, Mountain Dew. Mountain Dew is making some money here, Mark. Now, Jim Walker's got that first lap in pretty good, making up time that he lost in that first lap.
That's followed by Mandingo Bay, then we have North Carolina National Guard, followed by Miss Madison.
Jack's water from Mars running in seven. That's the...
There you go. That's the one that we're calling the North Carolina National Guard, what it says on the side.
Okay, come on, Jack's water from Mars, they did a great job supporting our North Carolina race. What a great event we had there in North Carolina, Mark. It was a great event. Great spectators had a great time. I heard the races did too.
It was fantastic, and it was just a week before the hurricane hit North Carolina. I know that Kerry and Jeff had their hands full getting everything buttoned up for the hurricane that hit 5 days after we all left North Carolina. Well, except for those of us who lived there, and then ultimately had to really deal with that. But glad we had the event that weekend, not the schedule of the weekend of the hurricane.
Yeah, it would have been a little rough. What do you think?
It would have been rough. I don't know. You and I raced in West Palm Beach the year of Floyd.
Oh, man, that was a big old rain.
It was planned.
A big old roll. That was like 20-foot rollers were jumping off the top of that.
I was more worried about a boat jumping off a wave behind me and landing on me than I was anything else in hell. That was a rough one.
Man, let me tell you, Orton Custom Marine is doing a great job. We got Jim McDonald on the driving and Mike DeFries throttling. They're doing a nice job of pulling away from J.D. Byrider, who's been probably the fastest boat or the most consistent boat of the year, I think.
Yeah, United Mark is also an accomplished supercat driver, as is Mike DeFries in the boat, and Tim McDonald, actually. As, now, Tim McDonald got a little bit of practice time in, as he and I were at the Lake of the Ozark shootout 2 weeks ago. So that was where I went out and spent some time with the front of the boat, so we got a chance to play a little bit.
Obviously, he feels really comfortable with the boat. Mike DeFries has got his hands on the wheel, and Mike has got a lot of experience driving, loves cars, loves boats. And he's certainly loving going out on these turns. He got out of there, wow, this is a lot of fun.
Yeah, very cool. What's it a good battle going right now for third and fourth place between Ocala Grand Prix and Peters and May? Now, Peters and May boats, with Austin and Kyle, have passed more boats this year than any other boat. They've been cruising on the start, got real close starts, but had to work their way back. understand they're doing it right now. They're really pressuring Orton Custom Marine right now for that third place spot. And I think from an experience in traffic, that boat has done more than any of the teams combined.
Yeah, they, and those guys, you know, they're the youngest guys on the race course too, you know, comparatively speaking, and they're really adapting well. Of course, Osmond just got back from running in Liverpool last weekend. He's been running the UK series as well.
He's been traveling, hunting, and now over here in the UK, the race is a little bit a rougher water race compared to what we have here. Probably less drive through the turns and more just handling the rough water than what we have right here with the dog legs, right and left-handed turns. So very different different racing, and these P1 Panthers have been successful both in the flat water and the rough water.
And they handle really well in all of it. I mean, watching these boats turn into these conditions. And right now, they've actually kind of spaced out a little bit more than I would have expected, although you're not seeing anybody run away. But most of the time, these guys are diving over each other's wakes in the turn, so you're always dealing with cross-chopping. The boats handle so predictably. When you get them in 4 and 5 footers, it's a whole different game.
Airtime with these boats. I'd love to take a ride on one of these boats like a 3-foot chop. That'd be a blast.
Nope. Man, Nico May tried to take a high line, and he actually high-sided the boat a little bit as he came around the turn. He's now trying to jump back to the inside as they went around the dog leg on the inside of the race course.
And here comes Jack's Waterford Park trying to make a run on him too, going through turn 5 and towards turn 6. Jeff and Cody are doing a nice job in that boat. As you take a look at running at 8, the Grant brothers and Miss Madison doing a nice job. They're running consistent after the first lap. They struggled a little there, but they're getting used to the boat. As you progress throughout the weekend, I'm sure they're going to get back. But still out in front, Orton Custom Marine, second place, J.D. Byrider, third place, Ocala Grand Prix, fourth place, Peterson Bay, fifth place, I think is Mandingo, right?
Yep, Mandingo Bay.
Mandingo Bay. Then we got Mountain Dew, then we got Jack's Waterfront Bar, and Miss Madison. As the exit is out of turn two, heading towards the dog leg right now, still in the battle, first and second place. Orton Custom Marine, J.D. Byrider. It looks like, I think that would end up lap 4. I wish we had Cherry at the center for us, right?
Exactly.
Where's Cherry when we need her?
All right, they're making their way around Cherry. Now, what you really got to watch right now, Charlie, is the sense that you get when you're out in those conditions, when you're out in front, is you start trying to find that little extra edge to go a little bit faster. That's when they push the up button one too many times in these boats, and all of a sudden, that one of those two guys up in the front goes in the Guardian boat for just a second, they are no longer going to be in the lead.
Ooh, man, that was that Peterson Bay boat. He cut that boat hard in turn 4, Mark, coming in, trying to go on the inside of the Orton Custom Marine boat. These guys have a great battle going from third to fourth, back and forth, back and forth, but Peterson Bay is trying every line available to him. So Ocala goes to the inside, Peterson Bay goes to the outside. If Ocala goes to the outside, Peterson Bay dives on the inside. If we take a look at going towards 6, let's see what they do. No, he stays wide. And now do they get by, so now do is running in fifth right now, chasing down third and fourth place.
We watch those guys out there running these boats. It'll be nice if they get a little bit more bunched up together.
As you take a look at the helicopter chasing the third place boat down the back hole, down the clutch runner, I should say the right, you can do video footage in and out of these turns. And that would have been lap 4, I guess we're on, or a complete lap 4, now on lap 5. We're almost halfway through this event, Mark. Great race, these boats are running real strong, putting up some good lap speeds.
Actually, we're going to see how this works out. Actually, I think I might have missed a lap. I think we actually have 5 down. Actually, you might be able to call race control, Lance. You've got the radio right there. Just double-check our lap counts. As that battle for third place still continues to be tight, Peterson Bay trying to come up on the inside of Ocala Grand Prix. Our leader continues to be Oregon Custom Marine with Tim McDonald and Mike DeVries. J.D. Ryder carves a hard inside line. Mark and Cody Kowalski, father and son team. Orton Custom Marine picking a good line, and J.D. Byrider now goes to the inside. Running right on the crest of the wake created by Orton Custom Marine. Peterson Bay has gone within a boat length again of Ocala Grand Prix as John Hansen and Java George Ariano.
They're good, but this is probably the best that in Mountain Dew, and we got to go. Here's the battle right now. It looks like the Drag Brothers are going on an inside lane, going after Jack Waterfoot Wall right now on the inside, going through turn 5, heading towards turn 6. Are they going to get him? It looks like they may get him as they head towards turn 6, side by side. Do the grass in this side of the invite? Yes, they do. They snuck in on the inside, got out in seventh place right now, and did get by Jack Waterfoot Bar and Grill. Now to send this side to that sixth place vote, which is going to be the Mandico mix with Kevin McGregor and Brian McGregor.
Right now, our leaders are just now exiting turn 2, heading towards the jump in for the dog leg. Oregon Custom Breed with Tim McDonald and Mike DeVries. Pull from the Portland area.
Boy, Mike's really picked up this single-engine racing here. He's been used to running these twin-engine, 150-mile-an-hour, inboard catamarans, and he's really adapted well to throttling a single-engine V-bottom.
Well, he's actually driving this thing.
Oh, he said he was throttling.
He said he's throttling? No, they switched seats.
Maybe they are. Well, maybe.
You could be right. I just assumed that Mike was driving.
That's what I assumed, but he said something when I was talking to Brooke. Maybe they switched back. I don't know. Maybe there was a switch.
You know, I was standing by the boat. I think you're right. Tim was sitting in the driver's seat.
Okay, well, find out. Well, Tim's doing a great job driving that old custom rainbow. But here comes J.D. Byrider. And here's our third and fourth.
Here's the guy again, trying to jump over the wing. Let's see if he's going to go back to the inside track.
Right to the center of the rooster now, getting hosed down. As they're trying to pick down the ball, they're trying to reel in a fella Grand Prix.
With George Ariano and John Hansen.
Yeah, Kyle and Austin are doing a nice job. They're trying, man. They're working hard. And Austin's definitely, he's been doing his push-up play. They keep teasing him. He's got to keep doing those push-ups. Took a little bit of hop there as he crossed weight. Again, Diamond on the inside. Is he going to get up? Does he get it yet? Going through turn 6 right now. But the Grad Brothers, Blake and Brock, have really grasped the P1 Panther boat right now. They're working their way up. They've gained a lot of time since that first lap.
I know Kyle's loving this because his grandparents are here, which happen to be my parents, and got a lot of family here watching him race. And I know Mike DeVries has a bunch of his family here watching as well. George Giriana's family is here from Florida, so we got a lot of people.
They came out.
Yeah,
but you couldn't.
Why would you not want to be in San Diego?
I was going to say, there's definitely a fan day here with the weather. It's beautiful. We couldn't have asked for better weather anywhere in the country, and here we are in San Diego. Enjoying great weather and great powerboat racing as we take a look at Oregon Custom Race. Still out in front. J.D. Byrider running a strong second. That's with Mark Cody Kowalski, again, at the father and son team, I should say, doing a nice job running a strong second. And the other family affair we got out there is Blake and Brock Gratton, who are in the Miss Madison boat, and their father, Joey Gratton, sitting on the sideline here, watching their sons collide, having a great day here as we take a look at Peterson, they still cannot get around Ocala Grand Prix.
He had a lot of experience in Ocala Grand Prix boat. George used to run in the B class years ago. John has driven all kinds of different categories of boat racing, so he knows how to pick a line. He's definitely making those boys work.
What's surprising is the Mount Dew boat. Those guys that have run strong last.
Oh, he's got it to the inside. He's now deck to deck with Mandico Bay. He almost ran an overlap. Got his nose right under the tail.
Oh, he's never in an overlap. He's got it. He's got the inside lane. The shortest distance around the third right now. They're going to come out of this turn 6 with 6th place. Let's see. Here they go. Blake and Brock doing a nice pass. Joey's got to be proud sitting on the sideline. I'm sure he's talking to his wife, Priscilla Grass, or Priscilla's listening on the internet right now. But Blake and Brock have done a nice job working from 8th place all the way up to 6th place as this race progresses. So they're doing a great job here.
Our leader continues to be Oregon Custom Marine as they just now make their way to the inside dogleg right-hand turn. See a little bit of a difference in the way these boats turn compared to all the catamarans you watch or the hydroplanes you watch run. They really just carve a sharp turn. The V-bottles will carve a turn to an extent, but they also slide through the turn. So I'll let these boats drift just a little bit.
Yep, and there's our first place boat, or that's going to be Tim McDonald, Mike DeVries. Second place, we got J.D. Byron and Mark and Cody Kowalski running a strong second. Here's still that consistent battle for third and fourth place. Whoa, Peter DeMay slides through turn 4 He still continues to make that run against Ocala Grand Prix. Now, Ocala Grand Prix, as Mark mentioned, these guys have a lot of experience with George and John. They've had that look. They do a lot of testing between events, so it looks like the testing has paid off. Because Kyle and Austin have not been able to get up to the transom to make that pass.
I know that Tyler Dan's got to be pretty thrilled with how he's been doing all year. He runs a 21-foot boat in the UK in the Superstock Series. That's the one they call the 150 class. And over here, he's running in the Panther class.
As I mentioned before, the Matt Dubo, Jim Armick, and Mike Sadlon, they were a pretty aggressive team the last couple of events. And just right now, this team, I think, got the good setup right now. They're not gaining, not losing. But I would have expected those guys to make more of a run today. Here in San Diego.
Now, one thing we did do, Charlie, is all the boats got topped off with fuel this morning, so they are all running heavy. You're going to see boats all run faster as the course of the weekend goes on. They will not have to add fuel for the rest of the weekend. They'll be able to make it all the way through on what they have, so expect that the final heat tomorrow afternoon is going to be pretty quick.
It looks like there's a white flag on the face, but this should be our last lap right now, and I'm curious if Miss Madison, Blake, and Brock, and the graduate of that boat are going to be able to catch Jim Armis and Mount Dubo by the end of this last lap right here. But here's our leaders coming doing this last lap. Morgan Custom Marine out in front. We got Mike DeFries and Tim McDonald with a great job. They've led from start to finish, running a strong second. Mark and Cody Kowalski, again, that father and son team. The Kowalskis, they're a big family affair here because Mark's other son, Corey Kowalski, is racing in the Jack Waterford Bar boat, and they're currently running in seventh place. And here's our battle for third and fourth. It does not look like it's going to happen, but it looks like Ocala Grand Prix is going to hold off Peters and May as they
Peters and May just right on the inside of that wake, though, Charlie. They're trying to make up the ground. Not happening.
Now, they've tried more bodies, I think, this race than anybody else has tried, but they just have not been able to get up to the transom to gain that edge going in out of the turn. So it looks like they're going to, here we get the battle right now. Is Miss Madison going to catch Mount Dew? It's going to be tight right now because Madison's really running strong. Blake, and we got a battle for 7th and 8th place right now. It looks like, is that Jack's water from Barney? No, that's Mandigo on the inside. Looks like they're going to have a side-by-side battle down at the south shore here. Ooh, side-by-side. Looks like there was rubber right there. Heading towards turn 6, Mandigo. And Jack Waterfront Bar, side-by-side through turn 6. Who's going to have the edge? It looks like Mandigo's going to have the inside. But down the back straightaway, it looks like still it's going to be Mount Dew is going to take 5th place. It looks like 6th place is going to go to Miss Madison with Blake and Brock Grapp. And 7th place gonna, looks like stay Mandigo Bay. And 8th place is going to be Jack Waterfront Bar. It's been a great race here, Mark. That's 10 laps down and strong race for our round nine number 8.
That's right. And what you'll see next year for the B1 Superstocks later this afternoon is they will be doing their qualify for tomorrow, which will start there around 9 and 10. And they will be out just running heat laps for time. Fastest lap gets to pick their lane choice for tomorrow's race. And in the second heat.